Was that the DA?
No, it's a hospital. Justine's condition is still critical.
She's gonna make it.
I should never have tried to talk to her.
Honey, it's gonna be all right. District Attorney Rosner believes in you. That's why I agreed to search Brett's house again.
Oh, he's not concerned about me. He's worried about himself.
Who cares why he wants to do it? They're gonna find the evidence that's gonna prove you innocent. All we want them to do is just clear this whole thing up so the whole nightmare's over. Now, maybe that's Rosner now.
Excuse me, could I borrow your mirror for a second?
Oh, are you sure you only need it for a second? Usually it takes me that long just to find my lipstick. Here.
I like that color.
Now I suppose you're going to want to borrow my lipstick for a second, too.
Oh, no. No. What I want is your advice. Will you help me out?
You want some advice? Forget the makeup. You don't need it.
Well, that wasn't my question.
Well, I'm sorry. I don't have time for any more.
Well, please, I'll make it quick.
Well, you better. I'm working here, honey. I don't get paid to sit around and gab.
Is your hair a wig?
Why? Is there something wrong with it?
No, I like the color. That's why I asked. But I wanted...
All right, just hold it right there. This borrowing thing has gone far enough. I don't know what your angle is, but you are not getting this hair from my head.
Oh, no, I don't want your wig. I want my own. But I don't know where to get one.
Now, what is wrong with the hair you've got?
Well, I look like a little kid with all these stupid curls.
Oh, and you think you're all grown up.
I know I am. I'm not a kid, and I'm tired of being treated like one.
Honey, you don't know the meaning of the word tired. You're probably thinking I should mind my own business. Well, usually I do, but you asked me, so I'm going to tell you without the double talk. Now, in my line of work, these are the tools of the trade. But we don't use these to make ourselves glamorous. Oh, no. We use these to hide the wear and tear. Believe it. We get worn out after one night. We're young, and then we're old, just like that. Boy, nothing makes me blush anymore. But you can't say that, can you?
No. But I'm not...
And you're not what? Not like the rest of us? Nobody beats the odds, honey. If you've got a choice, you take it. Nothing is worse than life on the street.
You don't have to convince me. I never considered it in the first place. I need a wig to hide my hair.
And what's wrong with being a blonde?
It's too noticeable.
Are you running from something?
I didn't do anything wrong. But I can't go back. That's why I need a wig. It's the perfect disguise.
Excuse me. I'm sorry, Mrs. Andrews, but this one corner room took in. I don't understand it. The others came out perfect.
I'm Mrs. Centel.
Oh, Mrs. Centel, I thought you were my supervisor. She's a real stickler for getting this right.
I see. I wonder, could you tell me where I might find Colonel Bluebird?
Oh, he went up to the pharmacy.
But you don't have to worry. He has been great about using his wheelchair.
In fact, he's threatening to spray paint a bluebird on the seat. So we'll have the same one when he returns for his surgery. Excuse me.
Perhaps he didn't go to the pharmacy. I mean, maybe he went to buy that can of spray paint.
Oh, please don't say that. My supervisor, she'll have my head if the colonel makes one single mark on that wheelchair.
No, I'm sorry. I just meant you really have to keep your eye on the colonel. He's full of surprises.
Thanks for warning me.
Nurse, Colonel Bluebird's surgery isn't too dangerous, is it?
Well, heart surgery is always delicate, Mrs. Centel.
But you don't have to worry. Colonel Bluebird, he's a good candidate for heart surgery. He's active, health conscious. There's no reason why there should be any problems with the heart surgery. But you probably would feel better if the Colonel were more of a talker. I know from having him on my floor that he prefers to keep things to himself. But that's okay, especially when a patient doesn't know when the surgery will be scheduled.
I suppose that depends on the availability of the surgeon.
Yes, the waiting's a hard part. But the Colonel, he's been wonderful about following doctor's orders.
Yeah, well, I hope I can enforce them at home.
Ah, that's easy. Just make sure he sticks to his diet, he gets plenty of rest,
well,
and that he avoids stressful...
Greetings, ladies, greetings! Don't look now, but this highly sophisticated and technical piece of machinery here is about to give the mighty punctual type a run for his money.
I think he wants his discharge papers.
Ah, yeah. Rev up, ma'am. Rev up.
That's impossible. The last time I looked, the prototype was in the hangar at TI.
Well, I'm talking about racing one around your neck. Once down the corridor and back, what do you say? You ready?
I have a bone to pick with you.
Have you two been talking behind my back while I was at the pharmacy?
Up, out of the chair, Colonel. Come
on. What's going on here?
Well, I think you better take this thing away while it still says property of Henderson Hospital.
Yeah, I think you better take me away before I say the same thing. You know what I mean, Nurse Colonel?
I'll get the distrust, please.
I can't believe I'm getting out of here. I, Kentucky Bluebird, being of sound mind and body, do solemnly swear to never set foot in a hospital again.
Hello, I'm Wendy Carter. I'm meeting Mr. Houghton for a business meeting. Is he here?
Oh, yes, Mr. Houghton has been waiting for you.
Oh,
may I?
Sure. I'm so sorry. I got stuck in traffic. That's why I'm late.
You're here. That's what counts. Well, may I pour you a glass of white wine? This is very lovely. It's a Sauvignon Blanc. You know this?
No, I don't.
It'll be my pleasure to expand your horizon.
Well, as long as they include Jonah, it's fine by me.
Ah, Jonah. Now, there's a complicated subject. As complicated as this wine, I might say.
That's why I'm counting on you to make it simple.
I certainly don't want to disappoint you, Mrs. Carter. But I must be truthful. So far, I've been unable to find the precedent you referred to this morning. You remember the names of the parties involved?
No, not anymore.
But you're sure it was a similar request?
Oh, yes. It was a widow trying to get custody of her deceased husband's child.
Well, that's a very unusual case. Do you remember how you first heard about it?
Yeah, I think it was a newspaper.
Oh, let's hope it was carried by one of the wire services. In any case, one thing I can tell you for sure, it'll involve some long and arduous research.
I see. Well, I could take a rain check if you want to get started right away.
Oh, that won't be necessary, my dear. My assistants are doing the legwork this afternoon.
But how do they know what to look for?
Well, they start by trying to find similar cases in which the mother has gone to jail or been judged mentally incompetent.
I see. Well, when do you think you'll have some information?
My assistants are very bright. I could know something by this evening.
Oh, well, then maybe I should stop by your office.
Perhaps we should meet for dinner. At my office, you might run into clients who know you. If I understood you correctly, the situation is extremely delicate.
Oh, yes, it is. And I want all of our conversations to be kept strictly private. I need your word, and I want your word that you won't tell anyone.
Let me assure you, what happens between the two of us will stay between the two of us.
Is Madame meeting someone for lunch?
No, Madame is about to have someone for lunch.
Where's the DA?
Did he find something at Brett's house? Is that why you're here?
Forget the DA. He'd need a magic wand, McCleary. Because that's the only thing I know of that can make things appear out of thin air. Except for you and Miss Wyatt, of course, who seem to have a knack of your own.
That's not true. The doll, just like the crib, the gun...
And the incriminating photographs, I know. I've heard it all. Trouble is, I haven't seen it all. In fact, I haven't seen anything. Neither has the DA. Or the policeman who turned that house upside down for a second time.
How do we know they really looked?
Because when my men do double duty, I don't like it when they come up empty-handed. That's money out of my budget, McCleary. My budget can't afford mistakes. You, Miss Wyatt, Mrs. Turner are three mistakes I'm not going to make again. The only reason it happened this time is because Mrs. Turner went to Rosna over my head and complained that I wasn't doing my job.
She has a right to her opinion.
Cagney, come on,
and so
ahead.
Do you. But you are overlooking one essential fact. You and Mrs. Turner are not impartial witnesses. Your emotional involvement is only making things worse. You lose credibility every time you send somebody over to that house for no reason. And how do you think that makes Miss Wyatt look?
Like she's been framed. Give me a break, Lieutenant. Susie couldn't shoot somebody in cold blood, and you know it.
What I know makes for an open and shut case. What I'd like to believe is something else entirely, and it's time you recognize the difference.
I never put my faith in facts. They're meaningless. Think about it, Lieutenant. Today my hair is brown. Tomorrow I dye it blonde. What happens to your fact then? A fact can be altered, tampered with, hidden. But when I know something with my heart and soul, with every fiber of my being, then it's the truth forever. Susie is innocent. And somehow, I'm going to prove it.
I'm warning you, McCleary. You take one step near the scene of the crime, for any reason whatsoever, I'll see you in jail. I mean it. I'll arrest you on the spot for obstructing justice. I don't want to see or hear from either one of you again until we're in court.
Don't worry. It's not over yet. Tell you how glad I am to be getting out of here.
Yes?
You know, lying flat on your back is only good if you got the stars above to gaze at.
Well, my home has a ceiling, too. And four walls.
Does it? I never noticed.
You will this time.
Why is that?
I'm going to eliminate your distractions. I myself will be spending more time at TI.
Oh, yeah? Well, we'll just have to set up a nice sofa there in your office for me so that I'll recuperate better. You know, it's a proven fact you deprive a plant of sunlight, it fades away.
Your room faces south. If you'd like to sit by the window, it's fine with me.
Well, I don't plan on sitting anywhere, to tell you the truth, because TR's still missing, and I have clues to track.
You can't be serious.
Sure, why not? Take a little walk down there by the river, breathe a little fresh air.
Now, come on.
Ask a few subtle questions. Couldn't hurt anybody.
Promise me you're not going to go chasing any leads.
Okay, well, what about if I walk while I'm chasing the leads?
I don't want you chasing anything anywhere.
Well, you just want me to stand still, let it all pass me by?
Don't make jokes.
This was my best maneuver yet.
Rollover wasn't so bad.
There's also a rollover and play dead. Glad I never got the hang of it. Don't try to make me get the hang of it now. You wouldn't like it.
You know that's not what I want.
Prove it. Race me down the hall.
No.
All right, then race me over to bed.
You are out of your mind.
What?
Don't
you never
do
felt
that.
Better in my life.
Will you stop this?
I can't. I gotta work up an appetite here.
Now, come on. Did the doctor say you could do this?
I ever tell you what makes you so special from other women?
I don't cry.
You don't cry. Great minds work alike.
There's nothing wrong with your appetite.
No, that's true. That's true. It just came back to me all sudden, like sudden. Would you like to, join me for lunch? I have mine in bed now, thanks to the hospitalization program.
I'm gonna go check on your discharge papers.
All right. That's what you really want.
Disguise is not going to help you when you're trying to hide from a pimp.
Well, it's nothing like that, honest.
God, you remind me of myself when I was your age. Of course, that seems like 100 years ago.
I think you're pretty.
I like a kid with good manners.
I'm not a kid.
I'm sorry, I don't know what else to call you.
Well, how about calling me Smitty?
Smitty. Now, there's not much to that, is there?
Well, what's your name?
Shalimar.
You're right. Yours beats mine by a mile.
And it should. I've got a perfume named after you. It's true. I have seen it advertised in magazines. It sort of cheers me up to think that I'm costly and exotic. You know what else cheers me up?
Meeting a sweet young lady like yourself, I hope you stay that way. You know, you've got a good chance if you...
Who's that?
His name is Lace. I got it from the shirts he wears. He's real bad news. I want you to stay away from him. Here. It's yours if you get lost.
Well, thanks. I'll never forget you, Shamma.
Just go. What is that?
My ticket to Vegas, if I find her.
It doesn't say anything about a reward there, Lace.
Oh, this filly can make me a lot more money if I can keep her for myself. Oh, relax, baby. You'll always be number one in my stable. Yeah, she's a high stepper. So keep a lookout, okay?
Sure thing.
Mr. Bouton, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to go to the ladies' room.
Certainly. Mervyn.
Mervyn, yes.
Shall I order for you?
Well, sure. I've already put myself in your hands.
Mervyn, good afternoon.
Oh, Stephanie. This is certainly a surprise.
Yes, for me too. I thought I might find you lunching here with your wife, but I believe that was my daughter who just left your table.
I knew your eyes were beautiful, but such accuracy as well.
Well, I have so many affairs to keep track of.
Excuse me?
Oh, charities, businesses, this and that committee.
Yes, of course.
It helps to have a sharp eye, Mervyn. So, how are Marcia and the children?
Fine, thank you.
Have you heard that Herb Newman has taken in a new partner so he can spend more time at home?
It's certainly something to consider.
Yes, isn't it?
Are you here for lunch?
Are you?
Oh, yes, business. As a matter of fact, we've been so busy talking, we forgot to order.
Oh, Bill, you must be starving. I know I am. You won't mind, will you, if I join you now that your business has been taken care of?
I hope you won't be offended, Stephanie, but it might be better if you didn't. What your daughter and I are discussing is of a private nature. You understand.
More than you know, Mervyn.
Of course, that's true of all attorney-client relationships.
What is?
Confidentiality.
Yes, but in this case, my daughter and I happen to be very close.
She made it quite clear she wants this entire matter to be kept between the two of us.
Well, that's why I'm so glad that you and I have this little moment alone together. You see, Wendy's already confided in me, Mervyn, and I would just love to hear what you have to say on the subject before she returns.
I wish Wendy were here to confirm that.
You doubt me. Well, why don't I tell you what I told her? The subject in question will never work out, Mervyn, no matter how much you and Wendy may wish to believe that it will.
Since you apparently know what's going on, let me say that...
What are you talking to my mother about? Well, darling, we're old friends. Did you tell her anything?
Certainly not.
Wendy, dear, is this any way to greet your mother?
Excuse me, Mr. Houghton. Would you give my mother and I just a minute alone, please?
Yes, of course. As a matter of fact, I have a few telephone calls to make. Stephanie?
Mervyn?
Nice to see you again.
I don't return the sentiment. How dare you? How dare you come here and spy on me?
Darling, I came for lunch.
Oh, come on, Mother. You followed me here.
Oh, my dear.
No, see, I know what you're up to, and it's not going to work. I have a right to lead my own life. All right. I'm sorry, but I do have to interfere. Darling,
I've been in the situation myself, and it's a dead end. If you continue this involvement, you will have nothing but a lot of empty promises and a broken heart.
You listen to me, okay? I am not a child that needs to be led around by the nose. You barge into my apartment. You intrude on my private conversation, so I have put up with it for the last time. Do you understand me? I am sick and tired of it. Now, I want you to stay out of my life before you ruin it for me.
Where does Bowman get off calling this an open and shut case? This is a democracy. You're innocent until proven guilty.
Well, Bowman and the DA seem to have that turned around.
That's why I have to find some proof.
Oh, you're not thinking of going back over to Brett's?
What other choice do I have, Susie? They're never going to search that house again. As far as they're concerned, the gun, the doll, and the crib are things that we thought up to get you off the hook.
All right, if you're going, I'm going with you.
No, it's too risky.
I'll take my chances. We did it before, we didn't get caught. And we found the crib.
It's different this time. The stakes are higher. If you come along with me, I'm not going to be able to concentrate. I'm going to be too worried about you.
Please, I can take care of myself. I didn't panic last time. I didn't cause us any danger. Besides, you need me to identify the evidence. For example, the doll's clothes you found last time. They were much too small for the doll I saw in the crib. And you would never have known that if I hadn't been there to tell you.
What about Jonah? If you put yourself in danger, you put him in danger too.
Oh, please, Kami, don't do this to me. I mean, come on, don't make me feel guilty. If you don't think I have my son's best interest at heart, you're wrong. I can't do him any good in jail, and that's what's going to happen to me if we don't find some evidence that will clear me. Now, let's please stop arguing and go over to Brett's. Are you coming?
Mm-hmm.